a brief revision. We completed the section of well completion. We divided the completion into two parts, upper completion equipment and lower completion equipment. Both are essential equipment that we have to use for any completion string deployment or running hole or installation. We have two equipment that no completion string running hole without this equipment. This equipment are the tubing and the bucker. Tubing and the bucker are essential equipment in running the completion. But there is other accessories that is used for specialized reason. For special reason, for the future operation on the well, we have to consider installing an accessories which will help us to carry out a special operation on the well in the future. This equipment, we discussed it yesterday, and we will also run on this equipment. We discussed the bucker function. What is the bucker? It's an equipment that is used to seal between the tubing and the casing. The tubing and the casing area is called annulus. This annulus should be always empty. No oil or gas or any reservoir fluids should be entered this area. This area should be always clear. We can fill it with a completion fluid. The completion fluid will contain an preserved fluid. Preserved fluid means clear fluid. Fluid contains diesel, contained a corrosion inhibitor, contains special chemicals which will be used to prevent any corrosion for the metal of the casing and the tubing. So the annulus is always filled with a completion fluid or to be empty. But it's not permitted to let the reservoir fluid to pass into the annulus, okay? So the function that the bucker will do in the completion string is to seal between the tubing and the annulus and prevent any movement of the reservoir fluid in this area. So the reservoir fluid will pass from the perforation into the tubing or lower completion, passing through the bucker and go up to the surface to the Christmas tree or the wellhead. No any movement from reservoir fluid. Reservoir fluid will be here in this area. This is filled with reservoir fluid in this area, okay? And a filling element is installed in the bucker just to prevent any further movement of reservoir fluid into the annulus. So, reservoir fluid is prevented to move to the annulus because of the filling element, rubber sealing element or elastomer, which is used to make the sealing mechanism, okay? This is the actual photo of the bucker, consisting of the sealing element and slips or dies. Slips or dies is used to make a metal to metal seal, metal to metal hanging, which used to hang when it activated, it's hang into the casing and prevent any movement or further movement of the tubing and the completion string. So, backing element will prevent fluid movement, making a seal between the annulus and the tubing. As well as the slips. Slips anchoring is used as a metal-to-metal hanging, which prevent any movement of the bucker and the completion inside the annulus. And this is the actual photo of the slips. And this is the backing element, which can be redressed or repaired at the surface once it running hole or retrieved. We say we have permanent and retrievable bucker. And what's the difference between both? Anyone know what's the difference between bucker, permanent bucker, and retrievable one?
The permanent one, you have to crush it in order to dismantle it.
Perfect. And what about permanent? What about the other one, the retrievable?
Retrievable, you can use it for other jobs once you're done with the current one.
Yes, but we can install it at first run. Okay, we can run in whole with retrievable backer, then install in the well, in the case the whole, once you want, any time after 2 years, 3 years, 10 years, you want to retrieve this backer again, you have the ability to do it with retrievable backer. But for the permanent one, you can't remove this backer without milling it. The operation of crushing this backer is calling the milling. And the milling is carried out by a miller. Miller is something has the shape of a drill bit. Then you can go through the well, running hole with milling string, then to mill the rubber element and the slips of the backer, so you destroyed it. Okay. We also discussed that we have many mechanisms of setting the backer with wire line. We can run in hole and install the backer with a wire line by electrical signal from the surface, and we call it electrical setting backer. Also by a hydraulic force, by applying a hydraulic pressure from the surface to a special port of this backer. Once you close the tubing from the end, you install a ball, you throw a ball or install a downhole block. Then you start to pump a hydraulic liquid, which is the completion fluid all time. Once you pump this liquid into the tubing, you destroy a shear bin. You shear a bin inside this backer and release the backing element and the slips of this backer, so it takes its action to hang to the casing and prevent the movement of reservoir fluid to the annulus, okay? Also, we have a mechanical set backer by rotation, by compression, by tension. All of these are mechanisms of installing the backer. Then